Hello, everyone. It's Donnell and Megan, and we're here with our last live before Christmas, because next week will be Christmas. So we won't be here next week, but we are going to share tonight with you a fun project that has a great use, and it's something that you can use as a stash buster. And for anyone of you that might not be template quilting yet. I appreciate you being along with us if you're not, but this project could be done without using any template quilting at all. Now, obviously, you've got decorative stitches. I haven't done mine yet. I've just done this short part of it here. I've used some decorative stitches right in this area here, and I did my template quilting down here, which we're going to do on the other end, because what we have here tonight is what is called a stole. It's a kitchen stole. And so I put the definition here on this second page for those of you that might not be familiar with this term. But what a stole is a women's long scarf or shawl. Now, I think that probably could be a person's now, because I'm going to show you how you can make this for the grill master. So it might not be a woman every time. But a woman's long scarf or shawl, especially of fur or similar material, worn loosely over the shoulders. So what this is I have this 6 inches wide. When it's finished, it's going to be 5 inches wide. And it is, I think this one is about 48 inches long. So as you can see, I use some scraps from the project we did a couple of weeks ago with the placemat. And here's the other end of it. So I'm going to be doing some cross hatching in this area here. And I'm not going to need to piece this, because you guys know what you could do with this. But this happens to be a Christmas one, just because obviously for the season. But you can do this for any season at all. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to show you that I had some strips that were 2 inches. I wanted to use this word joy. As you can see, it's upside down here. And then I had some strips that were 2.5 inches. So I've just mixed those all in there, not knowing exactly what was next, not having a plan, not caring. And those were just all stitched together. And then in this case, because I wanted to make this a fast project, I just pressed my seams to one side. It shouldn't be a problem because I used 60 weight thread to put them together. Now remember that 60 weight thread makes this lay a whole lot flatter. Now I'm going to make this, you know, pretty fast and easy, because that's the whole idea of this, is it's a quick gift that you can make. And again, like I said, it doesn't need to be Christmas at all. So the first one that I'm going to do is I'm going to show you here how I've given you some simple directions. But when you stitch the sides together, we are going to use 1/2-inch seams. But these seams here are 1/4 inch. So I didn't put that in the instructions, but you might want to when you're piecing this. Now think of those things that you might have. You might have a 4-patch laying somewhere. You might have a 1/2-square triangle. You might have a flying goose. You might, I don't know what all you've got, but you can put those into this and make it so you've got more. You can obviously make some and put into there. But I was just using some scraps from one of those other projects. And so when I said this right in this area right here, where I said to piece it, got to get it so you can see it. So it's either 40 or up to 48 inches long. The reason I said that is some people are taller than others. And you want this to go around the neck and hang almost to the waistline. Because then after that, we're going to put some kitchen towels on it so it hangs longer. And that way, when you're working in the kitchen, you got your towels right with you all the time. And if you need to, you know, take something hot out of the oven or whatever, maybe you can double up that towel and, you know, you've got your hot pads right there too. So it's just really a nice thing to have. Another time when it's great is for canning. I mean, it makes it so much easier to have those right there so that you can work with your canning jars and whatever. So you see you've got those measurements there. Obviously, I said right in this area where you're talking about the seam allowance, you're going to want to add that piecing it, you're just going to use your quarter of an inch. Now, I'm using fusible fleece because I didn't want it very thick at all. But if you wanted to, you could use even flannel, a piece of flannel there. And so that gives you the information. You can follow along as we work with the steps that I've laid out here and add your own notes as you want. Be sure to ask questions. Now, we're doing this a little differently tonight. I've got two camera views, and we also have this so that it is on YouTube. That way, we'll be able to put this into the university, and we will be able to save it much easier. So go ahead and post your questions. Megan's here to answer and help me with that. And we're going to go ahead and get started. We're also streaming live tonight right on the Westerly by Me page. So we're on there too. So if you have any of those questions, go ahead and put them on there. I'm going to see how good I am at changing things here. And let's see. Megan, you might need to help me with this. So how do I get that one on there? So we're there we go. All right. So as we see this, I'm learning as we go. I'm going to tell you something I'm going to do right here, right live in front of you, and I can't even believe I'm going to do it. I am going to do my star as a motif, and I am going to free motion quilt inside it. Now, that's kind of like, seriously, Donnell, you're going to do that? Yes, I am. I'm going to give it a try, because guess what? You never know until you try. Now, we're going to do all of the same things that we have done in the past, and that's pull up our thread. But remember, since the back is not on here, I don't have to have it lovely on the back. I'll be able to cover that up. Now, I couldn't get that up in there, so I'm going to have to get my tweezers. I do have red thread here, so it may not show up as much as I think it's going to, but we'll see. So we're going to do this star. And this is part of the Christmas motifs set. I love how all of you are sharing all the different projects you're doing with that. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to lift my needle up, but I'm going to just put it right back down close to the fabric, actually just a little bit in it, so that I can raise my foot up and go ahead and pull my template out of there. Now, I may be crazy for doing this. I don't know, but we're going to see what I can do with a little bit of free motion. So let's just get a start here and see. And guess what? I'm going over. I'm starting. It's not the rules that everybody else follows, because I'm just doing little squiggles all over the place. And this should encourage those of you that haven't ever done free motion, because I can do template quilting, but free motion is not really my thing. I've got a space back there I've got to get back to. I think it's a good thing I had red thread, because in the red, you can't really tell where I've been. You see why I'm not a free motioner? I hesitate. Some of you are going, I can do better than that, and you probably can. And I'm back to where I started. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to hit my finish button so that it ties off. And then I'm simply going to cut it so it'll pull to the back. And we'll cut these threads off that are on the front. My goodness, I've got my great big 8-inch scissors. Picked up the wrong thing there. I'm going to look at it first, you guys. It's not too bad. I still got an open spot, but it's not too bad. And it gives that just a little bit of a lacy effect, a little bit of smoothness in there. And really for those three strips, that's about all I need to do. Okay. So what I'm going to do up here in these strips, because again, I'm just playing with this, is I am going to, let's see what I want to do. I think I'll start in the middle. And this is going to sound crazy, but I can just find the middle simply by using my 3 inches. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go from this piece right here. I'm going to come down and then I'm going to move over a half inch because I'll be a quarter of an inch and a quarter of an inch away. So that's what I'm going to do first here. So let's get our thread in our seam pulled up.
I want you to know most people love your little tangled lights. Or
is that what they thought it looked like?
Yeah.
Okay, well, perfect. It is tangled Christmas lights. It's exactly what I was planning. Sounds great, Megan. I'm glad to know that it worked out.
That was Linda.
Okay. Well, anyway, I'm glad to know that it worked out. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to stitch down to this spot right here. And I'm going to turn. And this is where you could use your pathway template. And I think we used this a couple of weeks ago. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this and I'm going to put it right in there. And that way I can get my little stitching in the ditch. Now I want this to be a half inch away. So I have lines on my template. I can turn it this way. And let's see. This would be a quarter. So I went too far. So I'm going to come right back over. Oh, I didn't take my foot off the gas. And I'm going to come up this way. And I'm going to stop right there. And I'm turning it for two reasons. It's easier and you can see it. Okay. So now I'm going to take this pin out because just the height of that pin is going to get in my way. And I'm going to put this down farther this direction. And what I'm doing here is stitching in the ditch. So I'm lining up the line that's right here on this end because my needle's in the ditch. And I'm going to be able to stay right in that ditch. Now, I went way too far, so I'm just going to, while I'm down here, I'll do something, and that way it won't matter. And to cover this up, I'll go back and do a decorative stitch when we're finished over that. Now, if I had gotten right in the ditch, I wouldn't have worried about it. But right now, I'm just going to tell you as a person who is doing this for the FAST project, there's always a way to deal with some of those things that happen like that. Okay. So put this back down in here. I'm going to get right in that ditch. And this right here, I can go ahead to keep me from going too far. I can go ahead and measure with this. So what I'm going to do here is I want to do my half inch. I'm looking for my ruler stickers, Megan. Here we go. This is a ruler sticker. Right there.
So I'm sure some of you are like Flo, and she can't quite picture this with the towel. Don't worry.
Well, we're going to get it done.
You'll see it.
You're going to love it. So what I want to do is I want to be a quarter of an inch. So right there is where, does this look funny? But this works. Okay, you guys, I'm sticking this down in here. My foot is obviously on my machine and I'm pushing this up so that it touches right there. And so at that point, I know that right in that spot, when I go to the end, it's a quarter of an inch. Now, if I want more than that, like I want a half inch, I would put my half inch in here. Okay, now you have to remember, even though this is a half inch and that's a quarter, it's not 3/4, because it's taken off a quarter with the foot when it gets down here. So what I'm using in there is going to be a half inch. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to put that, I'm going to take this off because I think this is going to confuse you if I have two different things here, but I'll show you what I mean. Can't get my finger underneath it. This is kind of showing you some of my little, let's just say, ruler template hacks. So let's go right in there, and then I'll go ahead and put it right there. That's two ways to measure. So I've got it right there. I'm going to stitch in the ditch. Okay, so now when I turn this, I'll be able to line up this line that's right on this side over here. I think you can see that right on that side. And now I've got a half inch. Okay, so when I turn this direction, this time I want to go a quarter of an inch. So I'm going to take this and put that in there and get my quarter of an inch. And so now when I stitch, I got just my quarter of an inch. I'm going to pull this forward. And this time, the edge of my opening is right on that line. And so now I have my quarter of an inch. So let me show you that, what it looks like right here. Okay, now let's see what we've got left. We've got about an inch and a quarter, so we should be okay to go. Let's see if we go a half inch. I think I'm going to do another quarter. That's going to get me right back in the same space, Donnell. What are you thinking? Got to go over this way. And now we can come down.
So the question is, are you putting the arrow pointing to the needle?
Yes. So now I'm going to go a half inch. So I should be able to line that up to the needle and use my half inch right here. And see, it's at the needle and it's right there. Okay. So we're going to come down to here. I can't believe that first one I messed up that bad, but we're recovering. And now we're going to put the second line on the line that I've already stitched. So we're just creating kind of some random distancing in here. Some are a quarter, some are half inch. And so now that I'm here, I'm going to do two more half inch to make this mirror, okay? So we're going to come clear over to this right here. Got to go one more stitch to get in that ditch. So I'm back to the middle, and I want to go a half inch. So let's just turn this thing around like we've been doing it. Get our half inch. You kind of have to go at an angle to get it in underneath your needle and all. So you've got your needle bar here. We're lining up right there. We're coming down. Remember, I said we wanted to do two more. So let's get in that ditch. Went just a stitch too far. There we go. We're going to come right to there. And I think that's going to even us out. So there's the middle, 1, 2, 1, 2. So now we're going to do 2 1/4 and then 1 1/2. So let's just... Now what I did there is I used this to keep it straight. And when this gets over to that, it's at the quarter. So now all I'm doing is lining this up with that. And honestly, these are some of the things that help you learn how you can use your, your templates and some of these things that you have to get your spacing and that kind of thing. All right, we've got two of those. So now we want to go 1/2 inch. So we're going to pull this way. Get our 1/2 inch. This will be our last line. Because we've got, remember, 1/2 inch seam allowance. So what I'm going to do here is I'm simply going to turn this and come out into what will be that seam allowance and go ahead and cut that. Now, before we finish, I'll switch back and I'm just going to come back and I'm going to do a decorative stitch on either side of that. But that section is now quilted. So let's see. Let's go down to this one and show you how to get that cross hatching like I did it. So I'm going to take this, and this is where your lines come in handy. I'm lining it up over here with the 0. This would be the middle. So I'm just going to take a marker of some sort, and in this, what's going to be the extra, I'm going to mark that, and I'm going to get my crosshair grid. That is the 8-point. And I'm going to lay it in here at an angle so that I get them going up this way. So we're going to be creating diamonds rather than squares. And I've got my edge right here. And there's a line that's etched and a line that's etched. And then I need those two marks right there. So I am going to just use my chalk marker. And now that I've got those lines, I'll make them extended. And then what I'm going to do, because I know how this is headed later, we're going to use our echo guide to do 1-inch segments. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to mark this one that's going to be 2 inches away from the first one because my ruler is 2 inches wide. And this is going to make it so it's easier for me later, because when you have something this tall and skinny, you get to the point where you really don't have anything to measure up with. So that's going to give me a line. See how this stops right here? That's going to give me a line within my project. And because I found my center first, then that puts a nice, puts it right in there. Now, honestly, you could just do a 2-inch guide because this is not a project that needs to have a ton of quilting. But we're going to do a 1-inch. And so I'm going to be taking my, well, first, let's just go ahead and do this one. So I'm going to pull those threads up out here in the edge. Put the needle down in that edge. And the reason I'm doing this and lining it is because then I don't have to worry about all of this edge. If we had turned this first, had our lining on, and turned it first, it would have been very difficult to get everything hidden, all those extra stitches and things. And so this just makes it so much easier to do. Now, the first two lines that we do, we will not have the echo guide on. And you never want to run off of your ruler. So I'm just going to extend that down to there. And remember, I said a half inch seam allowance. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to raise my needle almost completely out of my fabric, put my foot up, and then I've got my echo guide. And this is the 1 inch, and you can see that one on there. So I'm going to take this and lift it up and push it underneath there. And I'm going to lower it so that that foot gets picked up. Now, before I pick it up, I'm just going to push down on my foot a little bit. And then I'll pull my temp or my echo guide up on there. Oh, that's just a border print that I have.
And, right,
it was just pick the other fabrics that went along with it. So I'm going to go backwards here because I can. When we get back to the edge, we're simply coming down that edge. Obviously, we've already got our line drawn on there, so I can just push this over. Now, you'll notice there's a little bit of difference here, so I'm just going to go back until it touches and then follow that, because obviously the line I drew in there is going to press right off anyway. Come back till this touches right here. And believe it or not, there's one more little corner right there. Now, since we're right here and there's a line there, I'm just going to go over those couple of stitches and I'm just going to flip it around so it's a little easier to see. And what we have to do now, rather than if we're going to stay on that line, that's 1 inch. So I've got a 1 inch measure. And that will put us right on that line. When I get to here, I'm going to just measure and tweak it a little bit. You don't want your line crooked, but you don't want it not an inch either. So right when I get to that seam, we're going to turn. And we're going to stitch out here and down this side until that. And I know you can't see it, so I'll turn it. I want that to touch that. So I need to come back up a little bit just right there. And like I said, this is giving you practice. So you would know how to do your cross hatching. I love to do cross hatching, especially when I'm making like the bags or the storage pouches that we make. Just right in that edge until this touches and put that template there. Now we're finished on that side. So I need to finish more of these lines. So I'm going back down that edge ever so slowly. That's going to get covered up. And I'm right there in that seam allowance. One more stitch. We're going to come this way. We're going to be in this little margin over here. Just that's why I said it's a half inch, so you got plenty to work with. And just like down at the bottom. No, actually, I don't think I need another one there because that's going to be in the seam allowance. So I got to look here and see where. Oh, look there. I need to come back this way.
Renee wants to know, could you do this on faux leather?
You can, but you just got to make sure you've got the right needle and thread combination. You can do this on that cork fabric too. Okay, now if, I don't know if you saw that, but my foot's a little loose. That's my sign. Get that screwdriver out. Tighten it up. We don't want a wiggly foot. That even feels better. So here we are. We're off the fabric. Doesn't matter. I'll get back on just as soon as I start. Measure my 1 inch so I stay right in that area there. All right, let's see what we got. I think we're finished. Yep. And notice our diamond stayed right in that center. Okay. So we're finished there. So we can cut that off. I started in the outer margin so I can cut that beginning thread off there. And let's see what we want to do here. Let's look at what do I have, Megan, that would be the joy? Which of my Christmas motifs would fit around that joy? Do you think I've got something? I know the star will, but I just used that. Take those papers for me. There we go. Let's see what we got in here. If anything will fit around the joy. That's not going to.
Oh, but your stocking, not your stocking, your, the light bulb sideways.
I don't think any of them are going to, but that's okay. I'm going to do the Christmas tree right around the joy there. So we're just going to center that. And I'm going to do that Christmas tree around the joy. Needle down, needle up. Now, if you haven't been with me when I do these, especially when I've got fabric that's going to hide it, like this is red thread on red fabric, it's just a matter of a couple stitches side to side. And I'm going to put this in the back so it's out of my way. And I don't know if you've experienced this, but I certainly have. And that is the fact that all I need to do is figure out which way I go best. And I know I go to the left best. If I try the other way, my tree will not look good at all. So after you have done some of these, you'll get to the point where you know which you like best. Now I'm going to go around it twice so it's a little bit heavier. And then I'm just going to do that back and forth and I'm going to cut it. All right. So now I can just simply cut this thread also. And down on this piece, I am going to do a couple of straight stitches this way through here. So I'm going to go right through the middle of these little snowflakes. We're going to line it up right on that edge. And again, I'm going to go back to make it just a little bit heavier. All right. I'm going to go down the edge here. And I'm going to, in this piece, line up off of that. And I'm going to come down to the middle. we're going to go a half inch. So I'm looking under them. It's actually going to be 3/4. And of course, yes, you could have just followed some of the lines because that's what it ended up there. And then I'm going to move down here and I'm going to be a half inch off of this edge. So right there, I can line up onto that seam. And come back. So the whole idea of, you know, what we're doing is obviously just to get it quilted. And so you can just play all you want with this. We've still got a little bit of a section here to do. We've got from that section to do. And so I'm going to go ahead, well, not that pen. Let's take out this pen. Uh-oh, I unthreaded my machine. And remember, I always like to take my thread and put it back in underneath there. So now, what do I want to do? Okay, here's what I'm going to do, guys. We're going to do something a little different here. We're going to start with this being the center. So I need to, since I really can't see through that, we're going to make a mark right there. And I am going to start with my needle in that seam allowance. We're going to pick up the thread. Of course, you could change your thread colors. That's no problem if you wanted to do that. And I'm going to put this on here so that, okay, now this is just showing you how I kind of play with my templates to know where I'm going to be. I need to look here because if I've got a half inch seam allowance, I don't want his foot to be out and cut off. So I'm just going to bring this line right here to the center, right here in this corner. Now, yes, I could get out a lot of things. I could measure. I could use my crosshair grid. But you guys don't know me very well. If you think I'm going to go to all of that work when I don't have to, I'm not doing it. Overlap a bit. And now, remember how I lined this up? I'm going to do the same thing on this other side. So I'm going to take it and I'm going to swing it this way and put this in the middle. Believe it or not, this one I can go both ways on. Well, that's weird, Donnell, but it's a design. Probably if I'd have changed my color, because you can't see this top part, so it gives this a kind of a funny look. Let me turn it over so you can see what I was actually going for. See how it's just like the two little gingerbread boys swung out either way. So, yeah, I probably wouldn't do that one again, but it's a quick project. I'm not taking it out. You just probably won't want to do that. Now, I'm going to find where my center is, and I thought I knew, so I'll show you when I get back here. This right here is the center, as this would hang around someone's neck. So I've got three that way and one this way. All right. So let's see. What do I have? Since I used templates in this one, let's go ahead and do that down here. And I'm just going to do the ornament. We're going to put that ornament in there. Now that I'm doing this, I'm thinking, why didn't I get out my mini fills and do snowflakes? I could have done that. Not mini fills, my mini spinifex. So now we've got the center here. And right in that section, I think I'm just going to wait to be able to do a decorative stitch. And again, for those of you that may want to do all of this with decorative stitches, this is going to give you some ideas of what you can do. So all I need to do to get ready for a decorative stitch is to take off this foot and put on my multi-purpose foot. You'll know it's a decorative stitch foot by looking at the bottom. Okay? And if there's no space here or no little extra height, then it's not meant to go over decorative stitches. So let me get something to compare here for you. So this foot is actually a better decorative stitch foot because there's a space out underneath here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to press this one off so that I've still got my ankle to use. And I'm going to put this one back on. Now, I don't know why I took the screw completely out because I don't have to do that to change feet, but I did. Which will allow me to remind you that when you go to put that screw back in, make sure that it's going in easily because you don't want to strip those threads. Very expensive repair. Because you're stronger than you think, actually. Well, now I've got to go back to my regular. And this will now go down. And I'll pick up my foot there. All right. So the other thing that's an advantage of your decorative foot is that it shows you usually where your dead center is. So I'm going to come dead center right here and put that down. And we're going to select a decorative stitch. And oh my goodness, there's so many to play with. But I'm going to make this so it goes fairly quickly. So let's do this one right here.
So before you get started, Jane wants to know, or Jan, do you need to change your stitch plate to accommodate for wider stitching?
No, I don't, because I'm using my regular stitch plate. I don't use a single hole stitch plate. A lot of people do, but I don't. And my machine will tell me. It'll say this stitch plate won't work with this stitch. Now what in the world? I've got super slow stitches. Oh, I accidentally hit the speed bar. That would have been bad. So now all I have to do with this, and again, you could change your threads, do whatever you want. And I'm just guiding that red little spot right here, and it's going to cover up this part right there. Yes, Megan.
Who wants to know, do you have to raise your feet?
Mine automatically come up, but yes, you would want to bring up your feed teeth. Very great observation, Ruth. Yes, mine automatically come up when I switch, but if not, you want to get your feed teeth up. And you can see this is kind of a heavy stitch. So you definitely would need to make sure you've got the right foot on so that it can go over this stitching. And this is really kind of a cool stitch to do here because it's got kind of this shape and kind of this thing going on. You would think I planned that, but obviously you know I didn't. Yes, I do have my speed all the way up. Someone's asking that. I do. That's as fast as that's going to go. So that you can see that the stitch that I put across there, that was kind of a heavy one. You know, it you can tell by the time it, that's only 6 inches wide, the time that it took me to do that. So now let's go over here and let's select something that goes a smidge faster just because it's fun.
And while you're doing that, Heidi wants to know what kind of thread you're using in your top and bobbin.
I actually have just a regular 40 weight all-purpose thread. This one happens to be 100% poly. And yes, again, that is my full speed when it does this. And of course you could do these, you know, in other places. You could do it, you know, not just on seams. I've got this one down here that definitely needs a stitch on it because that's the seam, that one and that one. And so I'm going to pick this right here. And on this one, I'm going to go so that I am guiding on this part right there. It's a hole that's a ridge that's a little farther from there. And I'm going to take this. This is a 9mm stitch. And I'm going to mirror image it to the other side. Always find something that you can guide. Because realistically, I am not watching my needle. I'm watching my fabric go into that place where I told you I was guiding. So since there's not, I'm going to do the same stitch on the other side. And since there's not something to guide, if I were to mirror image it, I'm simply going to turn this whole thing around so that I can just guide the same way. And then the stitches will be mirrored.
Why she's only seeing some of the comments, and I just kind of want to clarify because we're doing something new and we're streaming one video to three different platforms tonight, so it's kind of a big deal. We're on two of the different Facebook sites. We're here on So Steady as well as on Westerly by Me, and then we're also on YouTube, so we're reaching out, and that's probably why some of you don't see all of the comments. I've got all those platforms open up and looking between all of them. So don't worry, your comment won't get missed.
So I thought that this sounded kind of funny, and it did. I'm going to go ahead and put in a different colored bobbin because it won't matter because it's not going to be seen. It's gray and it'll be on the back anyway. But I got an issue. What it did, you see the difference? It's pulling up white thread. So I think I am going to wait until after I make this, and then I'll pull that thread out and deal with it then. I've got one more row down here that needs some stitching. Raise the presser foot and needle bar, and then turn power on again. All right. Sometimes you just got to do what the machine wants to do. And we will. So, Megan, we are going to put in a gold or yellow colored thread here on this one, because that's what I did on the last one. And for those of you that are wanting to know threads, this particular thread is 100% rayon. And again, that's where you can have fun playing with your decorative threads. Well, I don't know what happened there, but we'll try that again. There we go. And let's see, since it switched off and on, we can turn it off and get whatever threads or whatever we want here. So I think I'm going to use so many stitches, so little time. I'm going to use that one right there, and we're going to guide on the inside of that foot. Oh, sounds a lot better. So now it's time for my confession, okay? What happened to me on that other stitch was because obviously I had not paid attention to the fact that that red thread was wound on the top of just a little bit of white thread. And so when the red thread ran out, the white thread just started. So that's why that bobbin thread was white and coming to the top. Sometimes your machine can do magic tricks that you can't even explain. And that's what happened there. All right, this is a pretty stitch, you guys. Looks great on that. Okay, so that looks great. It covers up where I kind of got out of my ditch a little bit. We've got everything stitched here except my one bad stitchy right here. And I just want to show you, this will come out fairly easy.
So you got to rip out a little
bit. I might, but I might not. Okay.
Could you tell a little bit about the New Year's Eve party?
Oh, good. Maybe I will take this out then. Okay. So, Megan, if you want to get the handout, you can lay it over here. For those of you that didn't see it earlier this week, I believe it was Tuesday, but I could be wrong. I did a kind of an advertisement on it. And so we are going to be doing what is called the Celebration Star, starting at 6 p.m. Eastern, 3 p.m. Pacific. And the class is free. And you will get with that the designs that we're going to do. But if you want to make the star, you're going to need to purchase the pattern. Now, if you go and register for the class, I would say go to the events page on SoStudy. You'll be able to get registered. And when you register, where's the other handout? You're going to get these pages, which are the New Year's Eve party celebration. It's going to have what fabrics, how much fabric you need. It's going to have the things that we're going to use. And it's also going to have the menu of what we're going to be fixing for our New Year's Eve. So we've got a veggie tray, charcuterie board, whatever you want to call it, a creamy Tuscan chicken soup. We've got some four ingredient almond cookies that are awesome. And yes, they have coconut in them. But even people at my house who don't care for coconut like these cookies. And then I think we even had a Jolly Rancher tea. And that is where you take Jolly Ranchers and spice up your tea. So that's going to all be part of your handout. That's part of the free. This information is what you will get when you purchase the pattern. The pattern is on the SoStudy site. It is $10, and it's very detailed as to how you put it together. So for those of you that are kind of what you would consider yourself beginners, I have made these pictures so that you will understand how to put the celebration star together.
I have to share. Linda has already probably purchased this, it sounds like, because she's already got the recipes. She says she's already made the almond cookies and they're just about gone.
Yeah.
And that's so right. I'm giving you a heads up, ladies and gentlemen. If you use those almond cookies, you better make it like the day before because they go fast.
Yep. And it's funny because, should we tell them, Megan?
What, that none of us like coconut but you, and yet we all eat the cookies?
Well, that, but the first time we made the cookies.
Oh, yeah.
That was kind of a disaster because instead of Megan getting the, what is it? It takes evaporated milk.
You use
the sweetened condensed milk, but Megan got out some evaporated milk.
It was awful, guys. Just awful.
And the thing that was funny about it is even though it was awful, we still scraped them off of because they wouldn't mold.
We still ate them.
But they wouldn't scrape off. They were just like, oh, I don't know. I don't want to say mush, but.
They were mush. They were not firm.
They were mush. So anyway, that's our story. We're just plain old people. We'll tell you anything that you want to know. And we now make sure that we separate those two cans in the pantry so that we don't get mixed up on those and read twice. You know, that's just the way it is. So I don't want to take all your time. I'm not getting this out of here as fast as I thought I could get it out, but I will take it out and definitely get it fixed on after I've put it together. So I'm going to stop at this part. And what we're going to do next is, Megan, you're going to hand me this piece here.
Ooh, that's going to be pretty.
Now, I'm going to show you. This is going to be the lining. And again, you know, mine's like 48 inches long. So fabric cut across the grain, crosswise on the bolt, is not 48 inches long. So in this case, I had to add some pieces. So I added those pieces and didn't measure because, you know, it's a fast project. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to take and find the center, which is right there. And I'm going to find the center on the other piece. Stay over there. My table is so slick, it's sliding everywhere, which is good, but not today. And this is the center here. Let's see how we do coming down here. Okay. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to get my needle out here. And that was a decorative thread, and I don't want to construct with a decorative thread. So I'm definitely going to get a different thread here. And that gray will be all right on the bobbin because my pieces down there are gray. So I'm going to use gray on the top also. Don't go away there. All right. We are almost to a finishing point. Not really, but we're getting close. So obviously this is going to be a straight stitch here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and I am going to take this foot off. And because I'm going through this fleece, and I didn't do this a couple of weeks ago when I was using, and I should have. Remember those of you that joined me and we were using the heavy, like, polar fleece, and somebody mentioned, why don't you use your walking foot? And I didn't. Well, today I'm going to. Okay. This is not heavier, but it will be beneficial to use that. So I'm going to snap my walking foot on. It's called AccuFeed on my foot, on my machine. This is a Janome, and they call it AccuFeed. And tighten that in. And in this case, I need to change the plate. So I'm going to change the plate. It doesn't involve any screws on this particular machine. I just have to put it back in and it drops back into place. And this is one hole underneath there, so you're not using any different needle positions, that's for sure. And so I want mine to be right where it's at. And let's turn on that. So now what we're going to do is I'm going to start right there in the middle. And I'm going to put that foot down. Oops, sorry about that. I said to use a half inch seam. So what I need to do, and I'm going to show you this because this is something that you may not be aware of. When I put on my AccuFeed, it moves over. So this line is not, my needle is no longer centered. It's centered in my foot, but not to what it used to be. So I need to pick this up and I need to line it up with the needle. Okay, so now that I've got that lined up with the needle, I can come over to this line right here, and that's a half inch. Now, if I'd have just started stitching and used that line, it would not have been a half inch at all. Yes, that's why I usually sew. And my AccuFeed is actually helping everything stay aligned. Just coming to that edge, and I'm going to reverse, and then I can just cut those threads. This is the same side, I'm just coming the other direction.
this very interesting. There's a lot of people who don't know what a Dolly Rancher is.
Oh!
Like our UK friends and our Australian. There's also a few on here from the US that don't know, so you might want to explain that a little bit.
A Jolly Rancher is a piece of candy. It's a hard candy.
It's not a happy cowboy. However, that could be it, too.
I don't know what a happy cowboy is. But...
Jolly Rancher?
Okay. Jolly... All right.
Sorry. It was supposed to be a joke.
Okay. Yeah. It's just a hard candy that we have that will obviously, when you're making your tea, it will dissolve. So
it's fruity.
Yeah. Or it, and there's, I think it gives you a recommendation on the recipe, which one to get. Now, all I did was turn this around, and this time we can go the whole distance because it's just going to lay flat underneath there, and I'm guiding right here. And this is what 50-some years of sewing, for those of you that haven't been sewing that long. I had somebody, this is my bad stitching that's got to come out. Actually, it's down here a little farther, but I had somebody ask me the other day. And I don't know if it was just a joke or what, because they had to know the answer to this. We were in my studio when it was asked, and it says, they said, where is the place that you enjoy being the most? And I'm like, what a dumb question. When I'm sewing of any type, except for alterations, that's where I'm happiest. And we even have out on our little patio here for our studio, our mat, our welcome mat says, welcome to our happy place. So, yeah. And I have to tell you, when I said alterations, I had somebody ask me at the funeral home when I was there for someone's visitation if I would put a zipper in a jacket. And I said, are you asking me if I could or if I would? And the question was, if I could. I said, yes, I can, but no, I won't. And that's the truth. So what I'm doing is I'm folding this back, and I want to eliminate some of this bulk. So I'm cutting that side back with my pinking shears so that it's not going to be as bulky. And with this being with pinking shears, it's so much easier. All right, Megan, what's funny?
I wish they could see our bigger cat, Boo-Boo.
Oh.
Asleep. He is very intent.
He's very intent on watching me do this today.
Yeah.
He's looking underneath the arm of the sewing machine like, I don't know why she's cutting that. So anyway, you can probably see his feet right there.
Oh, they
there
saw
he
a little
is.
Cross.
Yeah, there he is. Hey, Boo. You want to say hi to him? Oh, no, he's going to run now. There he is. Yeah.
Also, several of you have asked if I can post the link for the New Year's Eve class registration. There is there a registration? I looked and I only found the...
You know what? The best thing that I can do is I can tell you it's either on the event page or after class, I will post it on the All Things Quilting page.
Okay, because I don't think there's an event up yet, but I don't know if it's just because it's...
And I don't know for sure, but you might be able to go back and see on the Tuesday event. I'm sure Stacy posted it there. So you could go back to the Tuesday page, which was All Things Holidays. We've been doing it every Tuesday in December. And we talked about it on this past Tuesday. So Stacy may have posted that sign up link there also. Now, some rotary cutters have wavy blades. And you might be able to do this with a rotary cutter. I think pinking shears are a little better than the wavy blades on this. And like I said, going back to the New Year's party, you don't even have to make the, you don't have to make the project along with this. Most of you won't. You're probably watching then remake it. But why I'm saying all of that is you'll gain something just from the information. I am not, and I put this on the handout, I am not making the whole star in the class. The focus of the class, I will be doing everything in the making of the star is done four times. So one corner's done four times, one of this is done four times. And so if you want to get it, Megan, we'll lay it out here so they can see it. So the star, the actual project. So anyway, with that being said, you can go ahead and make that ahead of time if you're confident with it. And then when I get ready to do my template quilting, you may be able to, you know, work along with this. But I am going to be using the ovals, and we're going to be doing some different things with those. I can't even remember what all else, but I know it's going to be a lot of fun. I'm loving the designs that I've put together for it. And everybody will get those designs. With the link when we send it out. So I'm going to let Megan put that out. There's the star. It doesn't have its borders on yet. Okay. But you'll have a star section down in here. This is an 8-point star down here, as well as the one in the center. So like I said, everything is kind of done in fours. And so we will be doing that. And then all of the designs that you're going to be putting on there are based off of that size of that star. So I think this is going to be one of those projects you're going to really enjoy. You're going to have some new templates there. You still got time to get those templates.
Somebody asked if our event for the New Year's Eve will be on Facebook only or YouTube. Basically, if you're getting to us now,
yeah,
that's the exact way
we this is, do. And that's the way we did, why we did this tonight. So if you can get to us now, and so when I say that, you'll be sent both links. So maybe you have a friend that says, well, I'm not on Facebook. They don't have to be on Facebook to join into this event. And what I'm going to recommend to you is maybe you have a group of friends that also, and you guys want to get together for this. So you could have a little New Year's Eve party of your own. And, you know, and I don't know if you guys know this or not, but most of you probably have the ability to take what's on your phone and broadcast it to your TV. So maybe you've got a big screen TV at home and you can just broadcast it. I may be causing trouble because there's probably a football game on at the same time. But, you know, sometimes girls rule. So do whatever. Be prepared for it. We're going to have a lot of fun just like we did last year. And we'll bring in the new year with a celebration star.
There we go. Thank you, Char. She found the link, so I'm going to make that on everybody's.
All right. Megan's giving you the link to get registered.
And registration is free, right? This is just kind of saving them a seat.
That this is, yeah, you got to be reminder. You got to be registered to get the link.
Oh, there we go. Okay.
It's not, you don't have to pay for it, but you got to be registered or you won't get the link. Is the situation, because the link will be sent out, like, I think they send it out like the morning of, or, and then again, like 2 hours before or something like that. So you need to be registered to get the link.
So they can't just hop on Facebook here or ever. Got it. Okay. So everybody's going to want this link to sign up. Now I got it.
Okay. And then the other thing I want to tell you about is Tuesday I'm going to be doing a reverse template project. And it's going to be on, and I know that this information is on So Studied, but it's on going to be on what's called the So Show. And it is at 2 p.m. Eastern Time. So you might want to join me for that. It's called Reverse Template. Really easy, a lot of fun. And we're going to be using the ovals in that one also. Megan, I need for you to turn on the iron. Now, what I'm doing here, I've done all of my cutting. But believe it or not, this is still wide enough that I can get down inside here and start pulling this through. Can you plug in the iron for me, honey? So I'm reaching back down in here and I just keep pulling a little bit more through. So it's really easy to turn, and that's why I made it 4 inches. Or 5 inches finished. I mean, I made it 6 inches to begin with because I wanted you to be able to get that through there easily. Nothing is more disgusting and infuriating than to have that problem. So what we're going to do is we will be pressing this right on that edge, and then that's going to get top stitched. I may do that later just to save some time, but we'll see. And then obviously we'll press it on this side. So I'm going to put the picture of the star back up in here, and I'm going to go press this.
So while she's doing that, this is a great time for you to go register. I believe I've put the link on all of the platforms now. If you didn't get it, let me know and I will share it again. For them to get the recipes that we're going to have.
That will come in the download.
That's going to come in the download. Okay.
I understand.
And that download that will have the link will probably come after Christmas. So even though they sign up tonight or have signed up previously, they're not going to get a link instantly.
No, they're not.
Okay. Just when some of you have asked. Looks like some of you are ready to go for New Year's Eve. If you're already, give us a thumbs up or some love. I'd love to see how many of you already registered. Oh my goodness, there's a lot of you. That's exciting to see.
They're coming to our party in your jammies?
Well, they could come in their jammies if they want. But we're seeing lots of them. I'm seeing you on YouTube as well as on Facebook. Good job. I'm so excited now. You know, it was exciting last year, but it's even more exciting now.
You got your glasses, Megan. You could share your glasses with them.
Oh, they're not as much fun unless they can see my face. And
okay.
I don't want to mess up the system of it going backwards yet. I'm not great on the camera angles yet.
I see. I understand.
Oh, this is a great question. Thank you, Bev, for asking again. I know somebody asked it earlier. Can they watch the New Year's Eve party later?
Yes.
Okay.
So and that's the main reason it's going to be done for the YouTube.
Awesome. Thanks, Bev, for asking that again. Yes. So those of you who, they would still probably want to sign up, though.
They need to sign up.
So that you can get the link. So still sign up so that we'll send you the link.
That's the only way they'll get the refund.
Got it. Oh, Nancy wants to know if they could get the cookie recipe sooner for Christmas. Well,
you know what? I'll put it up on my all things.
Okay, we'll give you a sneak peek just because you ask.
Tell them where, because they probably couldn't hear me.
Oh, on, where'd you say? All things? So we'll put the cookie recipe up on All Things Quilting with Donnell McAdams on Facebook. That'll be your little preview. Kind of like a trailer, a teaser.
All right. I am back. And I've got it all pressed. I turned this up a little more than a half inch. And this is the towel that I'm going to use. It takes a whole kitchen towel. And we have got it folded in half here. And I'm simply going to cut it. I'm going to tell you something that I think is kind of important. Don't go, you can buy towels on sale, but don't buy cheap towels. Okay? You don't want to go to all of this work and then have a towel that doesn't really dry. You know what I mean by that. So we're going to take this towel and we're going to find the center of it. And I'm simply going to put a pin in there because I need to take about 15 inches down to 5 inches. So I'm going to take this and I'm just going to fold this over to get a pleat. And you can see, like I said, you're just kind of arranging it. You could gather it up if you want to. I think pleats are really a little bit easier. So you're just, from that center, you're going to work left and right. Boy, I'm going to have to do more than that. Let's go here. It's kind of funny because I seem to be able to pleat better one way than I can the other. That was the center right there. So I'm going to pull that clear in so it touches the other side on the back here. And then I've got to pull this in a little bit more. And then what I'll do is I will actually be squishing that in more to fit inside there. Okay. So what I'm going to do with this is simply just stitch through it to hold it together. So I've still got my foot on there, my AccuFeed foot. This one I can make a little bit bigger. I can see that.
So since you're saying you're having some troubles with the pleats, I think it's Pecola wanted to know, would it help if you pressed it with an iron to settle it down?
It could help. Yeah, that's a good idea, but I think I'll be okay because this is not a super thick towel. I wouldn't want a super thick towel on this. But like I said, I don't want to stitch over my pens. All right. So here's my section. Obviously, I've got some work to do, but I'm going to put it in there on this side and pin this one. And I'm going to put it in here on this side. And I'm matching it up since I've turned it a little more than a half inch. I'm just matching it, the top up with that. Because I can still see in here, okay? So I'm going to put that side in and pin it. And then I'm going to just stick all of the rest of that up in there. Now, gonna even that out just a little bit. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to be stitching across the bottom here. Okay, this one needs to go up just a little bit more. And I want to make sure and this is what I'm glad I didn't start, because see here, this is not down. It's not pushed down. So I've got to release that fabric there and get this pushed down.
Could you use toweling from a quilt store?
You can use whatever you want. I use this because this is like what I like to use. I mean, you know, I want it to be so that it is kind of normal. This is the dish towel that I would like to use. So it's totally up to you. So yeah, I'm kind of maneuvering back and forth my pens so that I get them in the right place. And remember, I've got one on the back that's going vertical, actually horizontal to where I'm stitching, but we should be okay. So I'm going to stitch right across here. And you're going to want to go very, very slowly. And now that I've got it laid in place, I'm taking the pin off of the back, that one out of the front. Don't try this with a size 80 needle. You noticed I haven't changed from my 90 top stitch, because you want a good size needle in there. We made it. So I'm just trimming my threads off where they're showing. So now you can see that this is attached right on there. If you wanted to, you can stitch another row there, which I think I will. And let's just make that one up just a little bit higher, because this is all of that bulk of that towel there. Oh, yeah, that makes it lay a lot flatter. Perfect. Okay.
Crypto. She wants to know, is that a towel or a tea towel?
This is a kitchen towel. We got it at Kohl's. Megan waited in line forever to get this today. Mainly because it's the last Saturday before Christmas. Anyways, that's the story. Okay, so that's how we make that. The other side's going to be the same way. If you've got any questions, hit me up. I'm going to go ahead and quickly do this so that you can see it. I'm going to have to put this stole around my neck because it's sliding all over the place.
Oh, that hangs. Oh, never mind. It's not all the way around here. That hangs really low.
Megan. So I'm going to leave that in there. Take another one.
So Donna says she thinks she'd add oven mitts or pot holders.
You could do that. And you know what, you guys, I was thinking, I can't even believe I forgot to tell you. I was thinking if you wanted to, on the back of the top part that we did, you could even make a pocket on there for your phone. It's funny because I never wore sweatshirts very much at all. And now that I don't have a store, so when I go to work, I'm working in the warehouse. It's a little chilly over there. I wear sweatshirts all the time. And one of the main reasons I wear them all the time is I got a place for my phone. It's just so much easier.
So a couple questions have come in. Susan wants to know, what's the difference between a top stitch needle and a quilting needle?
A top stitch needle has an oval eye, and it's what we like to use when we're doing template quilting because there's more space for your thread to go through. So it is it has a larger eye in it. Megan, if you want to get my papers, they should be right back there somewhere, right behind my drawing pad. There's pictures of needles and I can show it to them. No, it's got a clip on it. There's a whole bunch of them together. Maybe it's in this Sew Study stuff there. So I got that one gathered up a little bit more than the other one. I'm going to put this in here. Have any more questions?
Yes. Julie wanted to know, she didn't join right with us, so she missed how long the scarf part was. Could you kind of explain that again?
It's on the instruction sheet that you can download, and it's pretty much custom, whatever you want. It can be anywhere from 40, 42 to 48. This one is 48 long.
Michelle also asked, are you going to sew after you turn the tube right sides out to stabilize it?
The tube's already turned right side out. I am going to stitch on the sides here, top stitch. I don't know if that's what she's asking. I don't know. But yes, I am going to top stitch that. You can see just my second time, it was just that much easier. And while I'm right here, I'm just going to take this and take that foot up and turn it and come up that little bit of a distance so that I can just stitch back. Oh, I was a little bit more. There.
So, curling son-in-law. I can't wait to see that.
Yep. I think it would be great for the grill master. Just don't make it too long that he catches on fire. Okay. Another Christmas gift done, Megan. Well, I got a couple stitches to do yet. So here's what we've got. These hang down this far. I've got my one set of stitches to take out, but I'm going to go ahead right now and I'm going to show you as we leave you today. Now I'm going to top stitch this because, as you can see, this is where I was talking about before you put this together. You can make a pocket right here for your cell phone. Just make sure you know which this is the top and leave that open. Otherwise, it's going to be falling out. But I'm just going to put this right here at this edge. Whenever you're doing something thick like that, you definitely want to be in control of your thread. And so we're going to say so long for tonight, and the next time we see you, we will be at the New Year's Eve party. I wish every single one of you a Merry Christmas. Enjoy the time with your family and friends, and we'll be back here on New Year's Eve. Bye now.